few years ago, in 2004, they decided to change producers, and they called me up and said, "Steve, can you come and help finish this record? What shall we do?" And they played me a load of songs, some which were finished, some which were half finished, some which didn't have lyric, you know, all that stuff. And there was a song that they did, that they had, called Native Son. Now this song, I have to say, this was a good song, and I loved it. And I said to them, you know, this is your best chance for a single, but to be honest, I think I could re-record it. So the version I heard was this. This is a song called Native Son by U2. I don't think it was released. Listen to this. Native Son by U2, and when I first heard that, I thought, wow, that's great. I think I might be able to get maybe 10% better production. So I said to them, can we re-record that song, Native Son? So I went in the studio and changed things up a bit, and I think got some more exciting sounds and a bit tougher. And I said to Bono, go in and do a vocal with the band, because here we have a finished song that you can sing, and we can do it like live, and you know, U2 are known as a great live band, so this will be a great way of recording. So I went, and he went in there, picked up the microphone and started singing that song, Native Son. Halfway through, pretty much maybe at the first chorus, he put the microphone down and walked it back in, and he said to me, "I can't sing that." I said, "What do you mean?" He says, "I can't go round the world for 2 years singing that song." I mean, Bono basically calls himself a travelling salesman. And, you know, he has to have the best vacuum cleaner ever to sell, because that's what he's doing. He's a salesman. And he didn't feel that the quality of that vacuum cleaner is great. Now, this is an interesting thing, because that is a great song, and most bands would accept that. And I've learned a lot from my production career, really, from the sort of dedication and the... I mean, there's no one I've ever worked with who is more... difficult? No, that's not the right word. More driven than Bono. I mean, he basically is Napoleon. I mean, he's a little guy with big ideas. And anyway, back to my story. So there we were. Oh, here I am in East Village Radio. Feel free to call 212-254-7104. Instant message me on East Village Radio, or I'm on the twit at EV Radio. I'm also on the Twitter, Steve Lillywhite, actually. Just get me on Sillywhite, S for sugar, Illywhite. So anyway, there we are. We've now recorded the track with you two, and I'm probably going to get killed by various management are going to call me up if they ever hear this, because I'm going to play you some things that no one in the world has ever heard. It's the process now of Bono coming up with different stuff to try and sing. This is just something I have on my iTunes from 2004. This is the 12th of March 2004. Just listen to this. This is just a little bit. I'll give you a hint of what we're doing here. You're going to hear, I think the verses are all pretty gobbledygook, but you'll hear different choruses. Here we go. This, there's no lyrics. Listen to the lyrics. There aren't any. Okay, so that is one version of a new verse. A new chorus, really. Here's another version of a new chorus. You've got to stick with me here, guys. Okay, so I think you'll hear... Well, you wait for the chorus, you'll hear... This is called... The Fast Cars chorus. Down, you go, you want myself, I need to take you where you want to go, you're not, I'm not, I feel like I can do you wrong, you mean, you're not yourself, you're something. That's the Fast Cars chorus. That one didn't make it. But actually, you know, I don't know if anyone is familiar with U2, but they did actually have a song called Fast Cars. Anyway, Bono will use the same lyric and he'll spin them around different songs. Well, you know, another few hours went by and Edge decided to do a guitar. So we then got into a sort of different feel and listen to how Bono's now singing this chorus. Actually, that one sounds pretty good, you see. And then that might go into another song, and they might, you know, so very often a U2 song will split into two songs. Now, you heard the melody on that last one there. It's la-da-da-da. It was pretty good. Now, that one could run in parallel with Vertigo that it became. And a whole new song could spring from that. But anyway, so the days would go by and we would try all these different choruses. And I would love to tell you, actually, that you know, when Bono came up with Hello, Hello, I'm at a place called Vertigo, which was a pretty big song for them, that we all went, woohoo, let's high five and go out and get drunk. But in fact, it didn't happen. No one really thought, oh, that's a great chorus. We just went, ah, that's good. And then we came in the next day and played it to some friends. And they went, oh, I like that one. I like the way that goes now. So it sort of just became the chorus by default. But that just gives you a little bit of insight into what I do. And just if you're not fed up with Vertigo... yet, I'm going to look for the finished version and play you that one, just to remind you how it ended up. Hang on, just let me type Vertigo, here we go. Just to remind you how it goes. Here we go, Vertigo. It's a beautiful sunny day here in the East Village. Yeah, East Village Radio in the East Village. Strange that, isn't it? If anyone wants to be famous and on the radio, just call me on 212-254-7104, or you could instant message us on East Village Radio, or tweet Twitter, tweet, whatever that thing is, who knows. I'm on it, though, Silly White. I need more followers on Twitter, so please, if anyone's listening, Silly White. There's always some silly stuff going on. Okay, thank you, Jonathan, for your instant message. But anyway.